There are regions full of mysteries hidden in the depths of space, areas that humanity is eagerly waiting to discover. The stars, planets, and galaxies in the sky hold thousands of secrets in the universe far from us. With this documentary, we invite you to the fascinating and mysterious world of space. Space is like a labyrinth that preserves its mystery in endless darkness. As a result of billions of years of evolution, shining stars in the sky, complex galaxies, and huge planets push the limits of the human mind. However, behind all these dazzling sights, a desire has arisen to dig deeper to unravel the mysteries of the universe. The Oort cloud is an important concept that forms the focus of this documentary and takes viewers into previously unexplored territory. Named after the famous astronomer Jan Oort, this cloud is a huge reservoir of icy celestial objects located far beyond the solar system. The Oort cloud is an area of discovery that offers important clues about the past and future of the universe with its mysterious objects, especially comets. It is a hypothetical repository of celestial bodies located in a very distant region of the solar system. It contains large amounts of icy celestial bodies located far away on the outer edges of the solar system. The existence of the Oort cloud has been predicted by examining certain features on the orbits of comets and distant celestial bodies. But it could not be observed directly. The main feature of the Oort cloud is that it is located in a remote and cold region due to the icy objects and comets it contains. These icy bodies can be the source of comets that travel at great distances from the Sun and occasionally approach the solar system, forming bright tails. The Oort cloud hypothesis was developed by Dutch astronomer Jan Oort in the early 20th century. Using observations and mathematical models, this scientist attempted to explain the origin of comets and other icy objects in the outer regions of the solar system. As a result of his research, he thought that comets may have come from the outer regions of the solar system. Comets form bright tails as they approach the Sun due to the solar wind and other effects. However, the question of why these objects moved towards the inner regions of the solar system and where they came from was still unanswered. Another important factor that attracted Jan Oort's attention was the erratic behavior of comet orbits. The sudden appearance of some comets coming into the solar system from very long distances suggested that these objects had accumulated in a larger distant region. Oort suggested that gas and objects frozen at low temperatures could be found in the outer regions of the solar system, beyond Neptune and Pluto. However, since these objects were generally not very distant and bright, they were difficult to observe directly. He thought that the source of comets was a reservoir or cloud located in more distant regions, rather than in regions closer to the solar system. These objects could be pulled in random orbits towards the solar system from this cloud in the outer regions. American astronomer Gerald Kuiper has carried out important studies on objects in the outer regions of the solar system. Kuiper presented evidence supporting the existence of the Oort cloud in the 1950s and suggested that this hypothesis was important in explaining the origin of objects in the outer regions of the solar system. The Kuiper Belt is also named after this astronomer. British astronomer Brian Marsden is known for his studies on the orbits of small celestial bodies in the solar system. These studies contain important data that supports the existence of the Oort cloud and provides information to understand the origin of comets. Jan Oort's students and other scientists who inherited his scientific legacy also contributed to the study of the Oort cloud. These researchers studied the Oort cloud hypothesis using telescope observations, mathematical models, and numerical simulations. Oort's hypothesis, based on these observations and ideas, predicted the Oort cloud, a large, but sparse repository of objects in the outer regions of the solar system. The Oort cloud hypothesis has provided scientists with a framework for understanding the origin of comets and other distant objects and has inspired further research in this field. However, direct observations of the existence of the Oort cloud have not been made so far. The Oort cloud is often thought of as a spherical region. This refers to a structure with many icy bodies scattered in various directions in the outer regions of the solar system. The objects within it are weakly bound to the sun's gravity because they are so far away from the gravitational influence of the solar system. Therefore, the orbits of objects from the Oort cloud can easily be changed by the gravitational influence of the sun. The trajectories of objects within the cloud are often thought of as random and complex. Therefore, comets and other objects may enter the solar system from the Oort cloud in different directions and at different inclinations. The formation of the Oort cloud may have occurred in the early stages of the solar system. It is thought that during the formation of the solar system, a number of celestial bodies and icy material were scattered around the sun. The Oort cloud may be a remnant of this early material that was deposited at the outer edges of the solar system. According to another hypothesis, the gravitational effect of other stars passing nearby in the early stages of the solar system may cause celestial objects in the outer regions to be pushed into this distant area. These transition stars may be instrumental in the formation of objects in the Oort cloud. Galactic environmental interactions may also influence the formation of the Oort cloud. Other stars within the galaxy, molecular clouds, and galaxy transits may cause celestial objects from the outer regions of the solar system to accumulate in this distant storage area. The Oort cloud is a hypothetical structure located in the far outer regions of the solar system and is generally thought to consist of two main parts. This structure includes icy celestial bodies and comets scattered in a wide area around the sun. The first region, the inner Oort cloud, begins quite far from the solar system, at a distance of about 2,000 astronomical units or more from the interior of the solar system, such as Neptune. One astronomical unit is the average distance between the Sun and the Earth, and is approximately 150 million kilometers. The celestial objects found in this region are mostly large icy objects and potential comet remnants. Because the Sun's gravitational influence is weak in these distant regions, these objects often travel in circular or elliptical orbits. The second region, the outer Oort cloud, begins further away from the inner Oort cloud, at an estimated distance of 20,000 astronomical units or more. Objects in this region mostly include comets and can extend to the outer limits of the solar system. These comets, located in the outer Oort cloud, may occasionally approach the sun and form bright tails. The Oort cloud is like a kind of reservoir of celestial bodies spread over a wide area and forming the boundaries of the solar system. This structure may contain millions or billions of icy celestial objects, and the total mass of these objects can be quite large. However, due to its inability to be directly observed, the exact structure and contents of the Oort cloud are still largely unknown. The building blocks of the Oort cloud are shaped by the icy celestial bodies and comets it contains. These components were formed by the accumulation of materials from the early stages of the solar system. One of its main components is the large amount of icy celestial bodies it contains. These objects often contain volatile substances such as water, methane, ammonia, and carbon dioxide. These substances, frozen at low temperatures, can remain stable in these remote areas. Icy celestial bodies are the main building blocks that make up the unique chemical composition of the Oort cloud. The Oort cloud is known as a region where comets originate. Comets are celestial bodies originating from the Oort cloud and moving towards the sun. These objects remain under the gravitational influence of the sun and move towards the inner solar system. And in this process they may form bright tails due to heat and radiation. The Oort cloud plays an important role because it contains these objects that form the source of comets. Among the celestial bodies it contains, there may be objects of various sizes and compositions. These objects are materials from the early stages of the solar system that were deposited in this distant storage site. Each celestial body may have different characteristics depending on their evolution processes and environmental interactions. Comets are one of the important components of the Oort cloud and are celestial bodies that originate from or are affected by this mysterious structure. They are celestial bodies that generally revolve in long and distinct orbits, known for their characteristic bright tails. They were formed as a result of the accumulation of materials in the early stages of the solar system and various interactions from outer regions. These celestial bodies generally consist of cores containing ice, dust, and volatile gases. The Oort cloud is one of the places where such nuclei originate. The orbits of comets are generally elliptical and have a large period. These orbits are characteristic of comets from the Oort cloud, which generally originate from the outer regions of the solar system. As they approach the Sun, the ice and gases in their core evaporate due to heat and radiation, forming a bright tail around it. When comets approach the Sun, the ice and volatile gases in their cores evaporate and are directed towards the Sun. This evaporation causes bright and colorful tails to form around the object. The comet's tail is usually directed towards the Sun, but it extends into space due to the influence of the solar wind and light. By observing comets, astronomers obtain important information about the evolution and formation of the solar system. Observations of comets help us understand the chemical composition of the materials they contain, their orbits, and the dynamic interactions of these bodies in the solar system. Since it contains materials from the early periods of the solar system, it can provide scientists with important information about the history of the universe, with features such as isotope ratios and chemical structures in the components they contain. The role of outer galaxy interactions on the formation and components of the Oort cloud is an important factor in the evolution of the solar system. External galaxy interactions result from exogenous interactions that can shape the content and structure of the Oort cloud. External galaxy interactions include interactions with other star systems and galaxies closest to the solar system. These interactions occur through gravitational forces and can affect the orbits of celestial bodies in the outer regions of the solar system. Passing stars or other galaxies can push or pull celestial objects from the Oort cloud to this distant storage region. Galaxy transits and the interaction of various gas clouds with the solar system can affect the formation of the Oort cloud. These transits and gas clouds can change the orbits of celestial bodies through gravitational forces and intense gas interactions. Additionally, these interactions may cause comets originating from the Oort cloud to periodically move towards the Sun. The solar system is exposed to various environmental conditions of the Milky Way, the galaxy in which it is located. Elements within the Milky Way, such as other stars and clouds of gas and dust, can influence the evolution of the solar system. These interactions may play a role in shaping the content of the Oort cloud. The rejuvenation and evolution processes of galaxies such as the Milky Way may have an impact on the formation and components of the Oort cloud. These evolutionary processes can affect the contents of the Oort cloud by changing the motions and gravitational interactions of other stars within the galaxy. The Oort cloud is a remote and hypothetical region that still holds many mysteries for scientists. These mysteries are the issues that are tried to be understood about the objects in the Oort cloud that have various properties. According to estimates, it is thought that there may be millions or even billions of comets in the Oort cloud. This number represents the likely concentration of large icy bodies and comet debris in this distant region. However, these predictions will be further refined by future observations and scientific research to better understand the Oort cloud and its contents. Some of the objects in the Oort cloud may have come from other star systems that have passed through the solar system and are about to leave again for distant regions. These types of objects are called second passing or nomadic objects. Neutrinos produced by interactions around objects in the Oort cloud can be used to confirm the existence and content of this distant region. However, neutrinos are quite difficult to detect. Some objects from the Oort cloud can also be found in the interior regions up to the Kuiper belt. These objects can be considered to originate from the Oort cloud due to their contents and orbits. The Oort cloud attracts the attention of the scientific world with the ancient materials it contains and organic molecules that potentially contain the foundations of life. This icy region could be a tremendous laboratory for astrobiologists. The objects it contains may provide important clues about the beginning of the universe and the birth of the solar system. Comet debris and icy objects in the Oort cloud may contain preserved ancient material from the early stages of the solar system. These ancient materials may offer astrobiologists a unique window into understanding how life began and evolved. By investigating the presence of organic molecules in objects in the Oort cloud, astrobiologists are trying to understand whether the universe contains the basic components that would support the birth of life. These molecules may shed light on the conditions that emerged during the formation of the solar system and the evolution of life. The Oort cloud is generally considered a low-density region. This means that in the outer regions of the solar system, there are many icy bodies spread over long distances and over a wide area. These objects are generally very far from each other and sparsely distributed. This low density suggests that the Oort cloud is sparser and larger than the planets in the inner regions of the solar system. Objects within this cloud generally emit very weak light and are difficult to observe directly because they are located at great distances from the sun. Hopefully for future discoveries, the development of technology and advances in space observations may reveal the mystery of the Oort cloud. Next generation spacecraft, more sensitive telescopes, and advanced computer modeling may allow us to understand and perhaps directly observe this remote region. Towards future exploration, we have the chance to encounter a new region full of unknowns behind the doors that will open to the Oort cloud. Seeing where science and the desire for discovery will take us may shed light on mysteries not only in the Oort cloud but also in the universe at large. Even though the journey is full of uncertainty, the passion for discovery will guide us on the path to illuminating the unknown. Don't forget to subscribe for brand new documentaries and more scientific content.